So today, I'm out of the office again, just wandering around London, and I've come to one of my favourite venues, which is a place called Flight Club in Shoreditch. I shoot here quite a fair bit, so happy to give them a shout out. And this is where I'm going to do my next video. So this is all about watermarks in your photography, how to add watermarks. Stay tuned, it's going to be good. Might even play some darts. And what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another brilliant video here at Benham Media. My name is Nathan, and it is so nice to have you here. So today we are going to talk about watermarks and how you can put a watermark into your photographs. Now, this is something that's come up quite a fair bit within the Facebook groups that I am part of. It seems that not a lot of people know that within Lightroom, you can actually add a watermark, either your logo, your name, or the copyright icon into your photographs as you export your photographs from Lightrooms onto your laptop or your computer. This is a nice little tool. It means you don't have to waste a lot of time in Photoshop, putting another layer on, using the text icon. It literally just puts a watermark onto your photographs as you export it out. Now, you can choose different options. You can choose where you want your watermark to go. If you want to go to the top, you want to go to the bottom, to the left and the right, or even straight across the middle if you are sending out a photograph for inspection by a client. But first off, I am going to see how long it takes me to hit a bullseye here at Flight Club. As I told you before in the intro, we are at a wonderful darts-themed bar called Flight Club in Shoreditch, in the heart of London. For those of you who have not been here, quite frankly, this is one of the best venues you could probably have at a night out. You've got darts, you've got food, you've got cocktails. The menu is just so expansive that you cannot understand how big it is. It's a great night out for if you've got a date, or you've got some friends, or some birthday. It's a really good night out. I'm going to point out that I'm not sponsored by Flight Club. This is just a venue that I want to personally give a shout out, because they've been good to me in the past. They've allowed me to film here quite often with my showreels that we do, and it's also a great venue to do some nice photo shoots in as well. And they are very, very accommodating. So I'm going to leave any links to Flight Club down at the bottom. But in the meantime, let's try and get that bullseye, shall we?
You going to play now, Bobby? I don't know, but whatever I play, it's got to be funky.
At the count of three, I want everybody in the place to be to make some noise if you're down with me. One, two, three.
So I've been trying for about 20 minutes now. Still not got it yet. I will though, I will. Now that right there, perfect bullseye. I'm gonna pretend that was my first dart. That's what I'm gonna pretend. Done. Done. Well, That took a little bit longer than I thought it was going to, but do you know what? We got there in the end, so I'm not too bad. I'm quite happy with that. So let's head into what this video is all about. All about adding a watermark into your photographs. Now, by the looks of it, not many people realize that within Lightrooms, it gives you an option that you can actually add a watermark, either your logo or your name, or even the copyright icon before you export. So that dialog box towards the end before you press the export button. If you scroll down there, you'll see there's a watermark section. So let's dive into Lightrooms now and just watch this little tutorial about adding a watermark.
So, welcome in to Adobe Lightroom. We've not been in here for a while, have we? No. At the bottom, we have our three photographs that we are happy with and we're ready to export. But we want to add a quick little watermark to it, so that way we can sort of maybe copyright our work, or that we can advertise our work, so this is one of ours. It's in the process of exporting it. So once you go into File, and you can come down and click on Export, this dialog box will come up. Once you have chosen your designated file, where you like your folder where you like it to go to, if you scroll down, all the way down, you will see you've got the watermark option just down here. It will always be unticked unless you have designated it to be ticked. So once you tick it, it'll come up with the options just up here for you. Now, this has got the normal copyright watermark for you, and I'll show you what that means. So if you go in here, edit watermarks, so you've got the normal copyright here. Now, you've got all these little options on the side as well that you can come through. So this is, whatever's in this box is what will appear on your screen. As you can see, it's in the bottom left corner. And you can choose all these different types of options. So first at the top, you can choose the fonts. So you can choose whatever font you would like it to be. Sounds like that. Star, regular, make it bold. Anything like that, bold, italic. You can even select a color. So go into there, you can go into the black and make it black so you can see a little bit more better in the center. Coming a little bit further down, you can choose your opacity, so you can choose if it's right to the top, or you can make it completely invisible. But again, what's the point of that? Offset, angles, everything. So that's just for the shadow. And then you've also got the watermark opacity as well, so you can make it completely invisible or completely visible. And this one's a little bit fun as well. So at the bottom, keep going down, you can make it the size, any size that you want. So let's make it quite big as well, for just for this example. Also, you can click fit, it'll fit the bottom, or you can go fill, and it'll fill the whole thing, but we don't want either, then we want top of that. So we'll make it right at the bottom like that. And again, you can choose other little angles here. So where would you like it in? So the bottom left corner, right at the bottom, through the middle, at the very top, top right corner. So we're gonna have it at the bottom left, and then we can just simply save all those settings and you make it a preset. So we're gonna go copy right two, because I've already got a copyright one already, and we can go create, just like that. Now, when you export your photograph, if you take a look in your folder as it's been exported, and there it is, right there with your watermark at the bottom, boom, right there. But as I said before, you can change it about a little bit. So we go into our next photograph and we want to export this. So like I said, you can choose almost anything that you like. So if you don't want just a simple copyright, you go back in, edit your watermark. Like I said, whatever is in this box is what will appear on your photograph. So if we want to go Benham Media, and there it is for you as well. And again, you can change it up a little bit. So we're just gonna change it a little bit gray. We're gonna bring it into a bold. I'm gonna want this at the top. So I'm gonna come all the way down and we're gonna go top right, just up there. I'm gonna make it slightly smaller as well. Let's just choose another font, shall we? There we go. And again, I am happy with that. And we'll just go old photos. This is another preset, old photo. it will literally, as you drop down, you see you've got copyright, copyright two, old photograph, and you can set as many of these as you like. And once you've exported that, if you go into your files, you'll see there it is again at the very, very top. Now, like I said before, you can even do it with a logo. So if you've got one of your own logos and you want to add it into your photograph, you just go to the same routine to exporting. When you go down to the watermark, you've got this one up here. So you can choose a PNG or a JPEG image. So if you click on choose, and you can find your logo. So this is my logo. This is a PNG image. What that means is that basically the background of the photograph itself is invisible. So all you can see is my logo. Obviously a JPEG will have a sort of a hard background, but a PNG file means all you're seeing is my actual logo itself. Now with these options get a bit different. So obviously you can't change the font size because obviously it's a file. You can't change the color. What you can do at the bottom is that you can choose where you want it. So we're gonna put it at the bottom right this time. So down there, we're gonna make it slightly bigger so you can see it. Again, you can sit there as a fit or the fill, do all sorts of things with it. You can even change the opacity again so you can slightly dim it and all sorts of things. And if you go save, it'll come up another one. So you can just go logo, create, and export. And once you have a look again, you'll see it's back there. And we have our logo this time. There it is. So we've got the logo, we've got the copyrights, and we've got our own name. And that is it. Those are the three different ways that you can upload a watermark or put a watermark onto your photographs. And as you also look, when you are in your edit watermark drop-down menu, all of your saved presets are all there, you see. So you can sit there and you can just copy anytime you want to do it. And if you just unclick it at any time as well, it'll be done. Okay, right, that's it. Like I said, it doesn't take you long. It's not difficult. Let's go back to Flight Club.
And again, that's it. It's that simple. Like most of my tutorials, they're not difficult things. They are all part of the software that we are using. Now, I don't always use watermarks. It's not something that I religiously put into my photographs. But if you're going to share your photographs online, either on Instagram or Facebook, especially if you're going to start putting them in the different photography groups, it is just a nice little add-on, something that you can add into the whole, something that you can add for people to recognize your work. So you can see, oh, that's Ben and Media's photograph. He's a really, really good photographer. I might contact him because I might have a job for him. So it's a good way of sort of spreading your name, spreading your work about so people know what you are doing. Like I said, I don't always use it. It's an option. It's the reason why it is an option. But it's pretty cool that you can decide where you would like it in your photograph, how prominent you want it, how big you want it, if you want it at the top, if you want it at the bottom, if you want it straight across the front. So yeah, that's it. That's this video. Hope you enjoyed it. As always, if you have enjoyed this video, please make your way down and hit that like button. It means a lot to me if you do. And while you're down there, why not hit the subscribe button and turn on your notifications so that way you are up to date with all of our videos that we bring out. But until next time, thank you ever so much. Mwah, 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 mwah. Brother, it's caught in the crossfire.